Hi, hello everyone from Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. Today we are going to discuss about performance of algorithms in terms of asymptotic notations and amortized analysis. Myself, Dr. M. Purushottamreddy, Associate Professor and Head of the Department of CSE. So first here, what is meant by asymptotic notation? So here, asymptotic notation, asymptotic analysis of an algorithm refers to defining the mathematical foundation or framing of its runtime performance. Asymptotic analysis refers to computing the runtime of any operation in mathematical units of computation. Here mainly we have five different types of asymptotic notations: theta, big O, omega, little o, little omega. The time required by an algorithm falls under three types: best case, average case, and worst case. Best case means minimum time required for program execution. Average case means average time required for program execution. Worst case means maximum time required for program execution. Now, here first we discuss about big O notation. Here you see, for function g of n, we define big O of g of n. This big O of n, we write that as big O of g of n equal to f of n, function of f of n. So such that there exists a positive constant c and n naught, such that for all n greater than equal to n naught, then we have f of n less than or equivalent to c into g of n, less than or equivalent to c into g of n. Now, here we see that set of all functions whose rate of growth is same as a lower than that of g of n. So, that is the meaning of that one. Now, here you see, this is the graph of big O notation. In this big O notation, here we observe that this is the c into g of n value. This is f of n value. So, in most of the cases, c into g of n is more value than f of n. For example, here we see that suppose f of n value is some 3n plus 2. So, how to write this value in terms of big O of n? So, now 3n plus 2, which is less than or equivalent to 3n plus 3. Or 3n plus 2 less than or equivalent to 4n. For what value of n? Here we see. So for n equal to 1, we substitute n equal to 1. 3, 1 is 3 plus 2, 5. 4 into 1, 4. So 5 less than or equal to 4? No. So this is valid for n greater than or equal to 2. For n equal to 2, this value is, suppose n equal to 2, 3, 2, 6 plus 2, 8, 4, 2, 8. That one is equal. For n equal to 3, 3, 3 is 9 plus 2, 11, 4, 3 is 12. So, for n greater than or equal to 2, this condition will be satisfied and we write 3n plus 2 in terms of big O of n. Otherwise, we write it as big O of n square, n cube and so on. In bigger terms also, we can easily write, but we write minimum value, that's why we write in big O of n. So this 3n plus 1 always, it is less than equivalent to n square. For what value of n values here we see. Suppose you substitute n equal to 1, 3 into 1, 3 plus 2, 5. 1 square value is 1. Substitute n equal to 2, 3, 2 is 6 plus 2, 8. 2 square value is 4. Substitute n equal to 3, 3 into 3, 9. 9 plus 2, 11. 11 plus 11. Here, 3 square value is 9. Substitute n equal to 4. 4, 3 is 12 plus 2, 14. Less than equal to 4 square, 16. For n greater than equal to 4, this one is satisfied. So, in this case, we write 3n plus 2. We write it as big O of n square. Big O of n square. Similarly, we will take some more examples. Suppose the equation is in the form of f of n equal to n cube plus 2n square plus 4. Now, n cube plus 2n square plus 4 is less than or equal to n power 4. For what values of n we find? Suppose you substitute n equal to 1. 1 cube value is 1. 2 into 1 square value is 2. 1 plus 2 value is 3. 3 plus 4 is 7. 1 power 4 value is 1. Substitute n equal to 2. 2 cube value is 8. 2 square value is 4. 4, 4, 4, 4 into 2 8 plus 4. 16 plus 4 20. 2 power 4 16. So for n equal to 2 also it is not satisfied. For n equal to 3. 3 cube. 3 cube value is 81. 3 3 9 9 3 27 plus 3 square 9 plus 2 18 plus 4 27 plus 18 45 plus 4 49 is less than equal to 3 power 4 3 power 4 value is 81 so for n greater than equal to 3 this one is satisfied so we write this f of n equal to n cube plus 2n square plus 4 we write in terms of big O of n power 4. So in this way we represent any time complexity value in terms of big O notations. Next we come to another notation, omega notation. So this big O notation, it takes more time. This big O notation is used in worst case. In worst case time complexity representation we use this big O notation. Next one is omega notation. Here g of f of n is the given function, g of n is the function which you take. So now here f of n is always greater than or equal to c into g of n for all n greater than or equal to n naught. Here we observe that this is the c into g of n value, this is f of n value. Here the rate of growth of this f of n equation, it is always more than the equal to or more than the g of n value. Now for example, we will take f of n value is some 3n plus 2. Now this 3n plus 2 is always greater than or equal to 3n for any value of n. For n equal to 1 also we will check it. This one possible. If n equal to 1, we substitute 3, 1 is 3 plus 2, 5. 3 into 1, 3. 5 greater than or equal to 3. So, we write it as omega of 3n plus 2. We write in terms of omega of n. Yeah. For example, we'll take some more example here. 4n square plus 4n plus 5 is always greater than or equal to n square. Substitute n equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. So for n greater than equal to 1. So now this value is greater than. So here we write 4n square plus 4n plus 5. We write it as omega of n square. This is this omega notation we use it to represent best case time complexity. It takes minimum number of steps to complete the execution of the program or algorithm. So it is used in best case. Next another notation is theta notation. Now here this theta notation, here we see that c1 into g of n is less than or equal to f of n is less than or equal to c2 into g of n. F of n is the given function. These are the functions which we calculate to satisfying this condition. This theta notation is used to represent average case time complexity representation. Now here we'll take, for example, we'll take f of n values some 3n plus 2. Now here we see that 3n plus 2 is always greater than or equal to 3n. Is always less than or equal to some 4n. Suppose we'll take 4n. For what values of n we'll check it. For n equal to 1, 3 less than or equal to 5. For n equal to 1, this is not satisfied. For n equal to 2, 3 into 2, 6. 3 to 6 plus 2, 8. 4 into 2, 8. So this condition is satisfied for n greater than or equal to 2. So now here we write f of n, we write it as theta of n. Theta of n. So this theta, it is used to represent average case representation. For example, f of n is in the form of n square plus n plus 2. Now, n square plus n plus 2 is less than or equal to. Now, this is always less than or equal to n square. N square less than or equal to n square plus n plus 2 is less than. Here is less than some here 1 n square, here some 2 n square. So, for what values of n this satisfied, we find it. For suppose n equal to 1. 1 less than equal to 1 plus 1 plus 2, 4. 2 into 1 square is 1, 1 into 2, 2. This is not satisfied. Now for n equal to 2, 2 square value is 4, 4 plus 2 plus 2, 8. 2 square, 4, 4 into 2, 8. So for n greater than or equal to 2, this condition will be satisfied. And to write this f of n, we write it as g of n value is n square. F of n value is theta of n square. Theta of n square. In this way, we represent by using this theta notation. Next, relation between theta, omega and big O. So what is the relation between these three? Here we see that one. Now here we see that theta of g of n is always equal to big O of g of n intersection omega of g n. So this combination of these two is equal to theta of g of n. Now, here we observe that this graphs also theta of g of n, in this theta of g of n, f of n value lies between c1 into g of n and c2 into g of n, whereas big O of g of n, we observe that g of n value is always more than f of n or equal to f of n. Here we observe that in omega notation, here g of n value lesser than f of n or equal to f of n in all the situations. Now, in practice, asymptotically tight bounds are obtained from asymptotic upper bound and lower bounds. Now, here we see how to define this relation. So, running time is big O of f of n. It represents worst case of f of n. Big O of f of n bound on the worst case running time, we represent it as big O of f of n. Bound on the running time of every input. Theta of f of n bound on the worst case running time, theta of f of n bound on the running time of every input. Running time is omega of f of n. It is best case. It is also represents in this omega notation also omega of f of n. Omega of f of n. Can still say worst case running time is omega of f of n. Means worst case running time is given by some unspecified function, that is g of n or omega of f of n. So in this way, we represent best case, worst case and average case time complexity. Once again repeating, so here generally big O notation is used to represent worst case complexity. Omega is used to best case time complexity. Theta is used to represent average case complexity. Average case time complexity. In these three ways, we represent worst case and best case values. Next we discuss about little O notation and little omega notation values. So for a given function g of n, here, for a given function g of n, little o of g of n can be written as, can be defined as limit n tends to infinity f of n by g of n value equal to 0. This is the condition. Here, g of n, it represents upper bound for f of n, that is not asymptotically tight. Now, here, for example, we will take f of n value is some 3n plus 2. Limit n tends to infinity f of n by g of n value is 0. This is the condition. Now, here we'll take some n square value. Automatically, this value is equal to 0. Here, this implies limit n tends to infinity, n taking as common, 3 plus 2 by n square. 1 n get cancelled. So, here 3 plus 2 by m, substitute n value, 2 by infinity value is 1 by infinity value is 0, 3 plus 0 value is 3, 3 by infinity, 1 by infinity value is 0. So, totally you get this value is g. So, now write here, f of n, write it as little o of g of n value is how much here? N square. In this way, we are defining little o notation. For example, we'll take f of n value as some n square plus 4n plus 3. Now, here we see, suppose we'll take f of n, we'll take it as some n square plus 4n plus 3. So, how to represent this one in terms of little o? Now, here we see limit n tends to infinity f of n by g of n. F of n by g of n. So, how to represent? Here, limit f of n by g of n. Here, limit f of n by g of n. F of n value is n square plus 4n plus 3 divided by. Here, we take g of n value is some n cube, then only it will become 0. Suppose we take n square, it won't be 0. Or n, it won't be 0. Now, here we take n square taking as common, 1 plus 4 by n plus 3 by n square by n cube. N square get cancelled, remaining n is there. Now, substitute n equal to infinity. 4 by infinity value is 0, 1 plus 0. 3 by infinity value is 0, 1 plus 0 value is 1 by n value is infinity. Now, it will become 0. Now, limit n tends to infinity f of n g of n value is equal to 0. Now, write, then whenever this condition is satisfied, then we write f of n in terms of little o notation. Here, g of n value is how much? N cube. So, write this function as in terms of little o of n cube. Little omega. So, this here, little omega we defined as limit n tends to infinity f of n by g of n equal to infinity. Or, this also defined as limit n tends to infinity g of n by f of n equal to 0. Limit n tends to infinity g of n by f of n equal to 0. For example, f of n is the given function. We'll take it as some 3n square plus n plus 2. Now, limit n tends to infinity, we'll take f of n value some 3n square plus n plus 2. So, this will become 0 means, here we'll take g of n value is either 1 or n. Suppose we'll take g of n value is 1, it will become 0. We substitute n equal to infinity. Infinity plus infinity is infinity, 1 by infinity value is 0. So, we write this function as little omega of, little omega of 1. Otherwise, suppose here we will take n, in this case also it will become 0. Here n taking as common, in lower bound limit n tends to infinity, here n taking as common or n square taking as common, 3 plus 1 by n plus 2 by n square, n get cancelled, 1 by 3n, that value is equal to 0, 1 by infinity value is 0. So, write in that case, we write this one as omega of n, but lower value is omega of n, so omega of 1, so f of n is equal to omega of n, 1, small or little omega of 1. So, in this way, we are representing the given complexity values in terms of all these 5 notations. That 5 notations are one is omega, big O, theta, little O, little omega. So, in all these ways, we are representing that representing the time complexity of any given algorithm. So, any given algorithm, time complexity, we are representing in 5 notations. That 5 notations are big O, omega, theta, లిటిల్ ఓ లిటిల్ ఒమేగా. బిగ్ ఓ రొటేషన్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ వర్స్ట్ కేస్, ఒమేగా రిప్రజెంట్స్ బెస్ట్ కేస్, తీటా రిప్రజెంట్స్ యావరేజ్ కేస్. నెక్స్ట్ కమ్ టు అమర్టైజ్డ్ అనాలసిస్. అమర్టైజ్డ్ అనాలసిస్, సో ఫస్ట్ వాట్ ఈస్ మీన్ బై అమర్టైజ్డ్ అనాలసిస్? నాట్ జస్ట్ కన్సిడర్ వన్ ఆపరేషన్ బట్ ఏ సీక్వెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆపరేషన్స్ ఆన్ ఏ గివెన్ డేటా స్ట్రక్చర్. యావరేజ్ కాస్ట్ ఓవర్ ఏ సీక్వెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆపరేషన్స్. సో ఇన్ దిస్ యావరేజ్ కాస్ట్ ఓవర్ ఏ సీక్వెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆపరేషన్స్ ఫస్ట్ డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ప్రాబబిలిటీస్టిక్ అనాలసిస్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ మీన్ బై ప్రాబబిలిటీ? ప్రాబబిలిటీ మీన్స్ ద ఛాన్స్ ఆఫ్ అకరింగ్, ఈ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ప్రాబబిలిటీ. Here, this probability means here, in this case, here average case running time, average overall possible inputs for one algorithm. It is using probability called expected running time. Next, amortized analysis. No involvement of probability, average performance and a sequence of operations, even some operations is expensive. Guarantee average performance of each operation among the sequence in worst case. That one is called as amortized analysis. So once again, listen, probability analysis means the expected value of the running time. Amortized analysis means the average value of the sequence of operations. The average value of the sequence of operations is called as amortized analysis. Now discuss about amortized analysis. Here in this amortized analysis, we discuss about three different methods. The three different methods are aggregate analysis, accounting method and potential method. Aggregate analysis means total cost of n operations divided by n. That means average of overall the aggregate values. Overall all values, you find the average value, that analysis is called as aggregate analysis. So that's why here we write that formula as total cost of n operations by n. Next, accounting method. Assign each type of operation an amortized cost. For each operation, we assign some cost. Overchange some operations. Store the overchange as result or specific object. Then use the credit for compensation for some operation from some later operations. So in this accounting method, assign each type of operation some cost. That cost called as here amortized cost. The operations which are used in that corresponding algorithm or program, for that operations we find amortized cost values. Finally, we find average cost of all that amortized cost value which are included in that operations. So that one is called as accounting method. Potential method, same as accounting method, here also we done, but here potential energy, here will take only but store the credit as potential energy and as a whole. That means here, depending on the importance of the operations, we calculate the potential value of potential cost or amortized cost of the given operation. Finally, we find the average cost of all the operations which are included in that algorithm or program. That analysis is called as potential analysis or potential method. So first we discuss about here, first method in this one, aggregate analysis, first we discuss here. Now here you see that stock operations here given in this example, push operation used to insert the values into stack. So here we enter this values into stack S comma X, that worst case complexity is big O of 1. Pop values from the stack. Worst case complexity is big O of 1. Here multi-pop means at a time we delete more than one element, minimum of S of K. While not stack empty, we opt to stack empty, we delete the elements. Do pop of S, K equal to K minus 1. So let us consider a sequence of push and pop and multi-pop operations. Now here also that the worst case complexity of each and every operation also here is given. And the size of stack also is given, that is n. Thus, the cost of the sequence is big O of n square. Correct, but not tight. So this one is big O of n square. Why it is big O of n square means, here we insert n elements and also we eliminate n elements. and also we multiply up n elements. Totally, here n operations used for pushing elements, n operations used for popping elements. So some k1 into n1 plus k2 into n2 operations used for pushing and popping elements. This is always less than equal to n square. So here totally we use how much cost of operations we use means big O of n square. It is always correct one. Next, aggregate analysis. Aggregate analysis means depending on the operations for each and every operation, depending on the importance of operation for each and every operation, we assign the amortized cost. After assigning amortized cost, we calculate the total amortized value of that operations. Total cost, amortized cost of that operations. And finally, we find the average of that amortized cost value that gives the aggregate value of that given algorithm. Now, here also we'll take the same algorithm. Now, here that stack algorithm. Here we see that for pushing the elements and also popping the elements, it takes k1n plus k2n. We write it as big O of n. Here we'll take how many elements? N elements, pushing n elements and also popping n elements. The take average it has big O of n divided by. So how many elements included? N elements. So divided by n. So this value is approximately big O of 1. N get cancelled, big O of 1. So this is the average value of all the amortized cost values. So this one is called as aggregate analysis. Next. So this is another example. Here, by increasing a binary counter algorithm is given. So binary counter means increment a value of the element. Now increment a means array. So array value increment. So while I less than k and a of I equal to 1. Initially that position value is 1. So in position here one value stored in a of I. At a of 0 it is stored. Next a of 1 value, next another element stored like this. By using this do loop, we store all the elements. After storing the elements, so again assigning a of I value is 1. So again assigning a of 1 value is 1. Now here, for each and every operation, we assign the amortized values and finally, we find the average cost of this algorithm. So here totally how many elements we include? K elements. 0 to k minus 1 is k elements. So for each and every one, we assign one step count value means that that time complexity of that one is big O of n. Why? Totally how many elements included? N elements. Big O of n by n equal to big O of 1. This is the aggregate value of all that values. This value is called as aggregate value of that given algorithms. Amortized cost value. So this big O of 1 is the amortized cost of this given algorithm. Next, accounting amortized analysis. In this one, we discuss about second method. That one is accounting method. So in this accounting method, assign differing changes to different operations. For each and every operation, we are assigning different amortized cost value. After assigning that one, that amortized cost value is more or lesser than we compare with actual cost value. When amortized cost value is greater than actual cost value, the difference is saved in specific objects as credit. So if the amortized cost value is more than the actual value, then we'll take the difference value as credit value. If less than the actual value, we'll take amortized cost as TS. So once again, listen, in this accounting method, for different operations, we assign different amortized cost values. So next we calculate the total amortized cost value of that algorithm. After calculating that one, we comparing this amortized cost with the actual cost value. If amortized cost value is more than the actual cost value, then we take the difference of these two and that one is called as credit value. If amortized cost value lesser than the actual cost value, in that case, the credit value we take as amortized cost value. Credit value is equal to amortized cost. Here we see, here we want to calculate the amortized amortized cost value by using accounting method for the same algorithm which already we discussed about. That one is binary counter. Now here, let here $1 represents each unit of cost, the flip of one bit. Charge an amortized cost of $2 to set a bit to 1. Whenever a bit is set, use $1 to pay the actual cost and store another $1 on the bit as credit. When a bit is reset, the stored $1 pays the cost. At any point, a 1 in the counter stores $1. The number of ones in the never negative, so is the total credits. At most, one bit is set in each operation, so the amortized cost of an operation is at most cost $2. The total amortized cost of n operations is big O of n, and the average is big O of 1. So big O of 1. Here original cost is $1. So this value is equal to $1 means the amortized cost value is 1. That is big O of 1. Next, last method, the potential method. Same as accounting method, something prepared is used later. So what is the difference from accounting method? First, we discuss that one. The prepaid work not as credit, but as potential energy or potential. The potential is associated with the data structure as a whole, or rather than with specific objects within the data structures. For example, we will take the same increment of binary increment counter. So for each and every operations, for setting bits we'll take $1, for resetting bits we'll take $2. There are n operations is there, big O of n will take n time. This big O of n is the potential value, and we divides with here n operations is there, we divide with n, we get big O of 1. So big O of 1 is the amortized value of that binary counter value in this potential method. So in this way, we discuss about amortized analysis cost value. Amortized analysis cost value. So here in this amortized analysis, already we discussed three different methods. The three different methods are, one is average analysis, another one is accounting method, another one is potential method. In the average analysis, directly we calculate the average value of the total value. In our accounting method, first we calculate, we assign different cost values to each and every operation. After calculating total value of that operations, that one is called as amortized cost. Next, we compare amortized cost value with actual value. If amortized cost value is more than actual value, then we take difference value of these two, that is called as credit value. If amortized cost value is less than the actual cost value, then credit value is equal to amortized cost. Next, here in potential method, also we do the same, but instead of credit, we store in the potential value or potential energy. So this method is called as potential method. So this is means amortized analysis. Thanks to everyone.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.